Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is LeFrancois and today I'm going to show you how to set up a soundboard for your stream with StreamYard. There are very few free options when it comes to setting up a soundboard for your stream. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a soundboard on the application called Touch Portal. Touch Portal is a macro deck similar to the Stream Deck, except for it works virtually on a tablet or phone. You can download Touch Portal on a phone and also on your desktop that allows you to control your desktop from your tablet or phone. In this video, what we're going to do is set up some buttons that will allow us to play a sound file from that device on our computer and have that sent to our stream on StreamYard. In order to follow along with this guide, you'll need to make sure you've watched the setup guide for VoiceMeeter Banana on this channel. That will be linked in the description below. All you'll need for this video is Touch Portal. You can get it from the App Store or the Google Play Store on your phone or tablet. And you can also get it using the link in the description below on your computer. Touch Portal is a free option. It will allow you to create up to 16 buttons in total for free. If you want more buttons and more pages, the premium upgrade for Touch Portal is only $13. With that being said, we're gonna jump right into this video. Before we continue, I just wanna verify that you've downloaded Touch Portal not only on your computer, but also on a device, either a tablet or phone. Touch Portal will work with either an Android at 4.1 or higher and iOS 9.3 and higher. You can get Touch Portal both on Windows and Mac OS, so make sure you have both of those downloaded before we continue. When you open up Touch Portal for the first time, this is what it will look like. On the screen here is the tablet that I'm using with Touch Portal. These are all the button slots that are available for us. In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up a button that will run a sound file. So what we got to do is click on this button. On the left here, you'll notice we have a bunch of actions. These are all the actions that are available with this application. We're looking for a very specific application called Play Audio. You can also just search for it in this search window up here. We're going to create that action. You want to make sure that the audio you're using for this soundboard is either an MP3, AIFF, WAV, or MPEG-4 format. So we're going to go ahead and select the audio file. I'm going to use this buttons file. I'm going to open that and I'm going to add that action to this button. You want to make sure you're adding this action on the on press tab. This means when you press this button, it will play this audio. On the right here, we have the visual settings for this button. I'm going to make sure we have a transparent background and I'm going to select the icon of buttons. Then I'm going to save this button. We have successfully created a button that will play a sound file on our computer. Now we just want to verify that the button we created is working. So if we pull open our device that we're using, first thing you're going to want to do is hit the refresh button on the top right there. You'll see the button appear that we created just now. What we're going to do is click that button. And as you can tell, it is playing the audio from that file. The last step in this process is making sure that audio is being sent to our StreamYard broadcast, and that will complete this tutorial. And the way we do that is with VoiceMeeter Banana. So let's head over to VoiceMeeter and make sure we got everything set up correctly. If we take a look at our VoiceMeeter application and then play the sound file again, you'll notice that the audio is playing in that desktop source or the VoiceMeeter VIO source. All we need to do in order to send this audio source to the StreamYard broadcast is we need to toggle on that B2 button here. The reason we do that is because in StreamYard, we've set our VoiceMeeter aux output as our input source on StreamYard. That means everything with B2 toggled on VoiceMeeter is going to be sent to StreamYard. The last thing we want to do is make sure our StreamYard broadcast input source is correct. So what we need to do is go over to our settings. In the settings, go to audio and set your microphone to the VoiceMeeter aux output VB-VoiceMeeter aux VIO. Once you have done that, you've completed this tutorial. I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more content just like this. If you have any questions regarding the setup, feel free to leave those in the comment section below. If you guys know of any free applications that will allow you to set up a soundboard, feel free to link those in the comment section below as well. And with that being said, I will catch you guys in our next video. Peace.